There's a sound I love to hear. It's the sound of my Savior's robe as he walks into the room where people pray, where we hear worship, he hears faith. There is a sound I love to hear. The sound of my Savior's robe as he walks to the room where people pray, where we hear praises, he hears faith. You can hear our faith, Lord. Come awake my soul and sing his praises.
Thank you.
I choose this day to be grateful, Lord. I give you praise with an open heart. I'm waking up to heaven. Yes, I'm waking up to you. Oh, I'm waking up to heaven. Yes, I'm waking up to you. For always being good. For always being good. Faithfulness. Thanksgiving in your own words tonight. What are you thankful for? Make it personal. Lord, I thank you. Lord, I thank you. Lord, I thank you. Setting me free from bondage when I didn't know I needed your help. Oh, you set me free, Jesus. You set me free, Jesus. You set me free, Jesus. So we're telling you thank you. We're telling you.
It says in Psalm 100, verse 1, it says, enter his presence with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. But before that, in verse 1, it says, make a joyful shout to the Lord, all the earth. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. And so I just want to declare that just over all of us, God, just thank you for just make a joyful noise before the Lord, even right now. God, we just thank you for a joyful noise. Yeah. Yeah, God, we just say more. Yeah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah. And we just ask, God, just thank you for just the power of gratefulness and just being thankful. God, I thank you. Your presence never leaves us, but our awareness of your presence can go up and down. But if we stay thankful of his presence all the time, we're always aware. And so, God, I thank you for tonight. We thank you that you're already here. We thank you for your love. We just thank you for your forgiveness of all sins. We thank you that the veil's been torn. I thank you that our names are written in heaven. I mean, you can just go on and on for just being thankful. Thank you that we have a roof over our head. Thank you that we have lights. We have a guitar. We got friends here. We got a microphone. I mean, you can keep going. So God, is pray that we would overflow with thanksgiving, not just here, but just throughout the day, of just being aware of our blessings, of just who you are. I thank you that it's the greatest antidote to complaining or being critical is just being thankful for who you are. You can always start, well, thank you, Jesus, you died on the cross. Thank you, Jesus, I'm born again. And so I just break off, Lord, just any ungratefulness or complaining. Thank thee that we live in the promised land on the central coast. It's always a good start. And so, God, we just thank you for your presence here. We know we're just getting started. So we just say, Holy Spirit, would you just keep coming upon your people with your love, Lord? Yeah, we just bless your name, Jesus. We just thank you for who you are. And let's just all stay in this place of worship. We're just going to pray for the kids. So, Addy, can you just pray for the kids right now? Cool.
So we just thank you, Lord Jesus, for just each and every kid that's here tonight, God. And I just ask that you would just release just the Holy Spirit upon them, Father, and that there would just be a burning in their tummies just to know you more, God, and just to crave after you, God, that they would just start to just be in communion and just conversation with you, Lord Jesus. And so we just thank you for the kids. Amen.
Awesome. And then one last thing. We're going to keep worshiping tonight. If you guys thought we're doing a sermon, we're going to be worshiping. But just one last thing. We want to give you guys an opportunity if you guys want to bless you know, what the Lord's doing, and we want to bless Tommy too. We're not going to hand out the basket tonight, so we do have a thing in the back, that little box there, but also online. If anyone wants to bless, you can just go online and just do that right now or later. But yeah, it's simple as that. We just want to give you an opportunity. And so God, just thank you for anyone that's in lack right now. I thank you for just an abundance for every family here represented, that you would provide more than enough. Any family here that's in need, we'd ask for an abundance of your provision of heaven to come upon them tonight. In Jesus' name, amen. Let's go back into worship.
Make you want to dance, and that's okay.
Morning and the day.
about your love. There's something about your love. It changes everything. It changes everything. There's something about your love. There's something about your love. It changes everything. There's something about your love. There's something about your love. It changes everything. It changes. This is the air I breathe. This is the air I breathe. Your holy presence living in me. This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me. And I'm desperate for you.
Jesus, we just thank you for your spirit here among us. Lord, that we don't have to stir you up or make you be here. Lord, you just love to be anywhere where the name of Jesus is exalted. So, Lord, we just thank you for the behind-the-scenes work you're doing in everyone's life here. We just thank you, Lord, that we get to bring you an offering. You paid the highest offering on the cross. And we get to bring you an offering of thanksgiving and praise, and you fill it with your spirit. We just thank you, Lord. You're the only thing we want. You're the only reason why we're here. There's nothing else to live for. It's all boring. So we just thank you, Lord. We're looking for family, joy, peace, love, faith, hope. Everything that you have given to us as an inheritance, we want that. We just thank you, Lord.
Highest praise belongs to you and only you. Oh, highest praise, highest praise belongs to you and only you. Thank you.
Just feel the Spirit of the Lord is here with us right now. Let's just wait on Him. feel like this is just something that the Lord wants us to get very comfortable with, is blessing him, thanking him, praising him, and then his presence comes, and then it's up to him what he does next, you know? But what's in his heart is he wants to bless his people. He wants to encourage his people. He wants to equip his people. And we are all the ministry team. We all can hear his voice. So I don't have all the answers. I just know we're supposed to wait on him. So I don't know if you guys have anything.
I just want to just pray for just salvations for people that are either you're here or you have a family member. But it's the greatest miracle is when one person gives their life to Jesus. And so if there's someone that you're thinking of right now that's never come to Jesus, maybe just say that person's name. You can whisper it. You can just, I feel like we're just supposed to intercede right now on behalf of the lost, on behalf of the dying, the people in Santa Maria, wherever it is, San Luis Obispo. But God, we just lift up the lost right now. God, we thank you, Jesus, that you hear our prayers. It says the prayers of a righteous man availeth much. And so, Lord, right now we just lift up just the prodigals and the lost to come back to you, Jesus. It says whoever calls upon the name of the Lord will be saved. And his name is Jesus. There's no other name where people can get saved. There's only one name. Jesus says, I'm the way, the truth, and the life. And so, Lord, we just thank you tonight that maybe you've been praying for someone for 20 years, that they would just fully surrender to Jesus tonight, Lord. We just thank you. We thank you, Jesus, for salvations just coming upon your people, upon their loved ones, Lord. We just thank you. I just pray that even when people come home tonight, they get a phone call, they get a text message, and they would see someone, wow, I gave my life to Jesus. And so, Lord, we just thank you right now. We just declare salvations. It says, when you would get saved, is you and your whole household would come to the Lord. So we just declare over this place, over the families here, that all the households would come to Jesus in your name. Amen. Let's go back into worship. Cool. All right.
Light of the world, you step down into darkness. Open my eyes, let me see beauty that made this heart adore. Hope of a life spent with. So here I am to worship, here I am to bow, here I am to say that you're my God, you're altogether loving, altogether healing, altogether wonderful to me. Thank you. see my sin upon that cross. No, I'll never know how much it cost to see my sin.
Light the fire.
And oh Lord, please light the fire that once burned bright and clear. Replace the lamp of my first love that burned. Thank you.
Time, just the voices.
And I exalt thee. I exalt thee. I exalt thee.
Thank you, Jesus. Yeah, it says in Psalm 34, it says, I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise will continually be on my mouth. And so, Lord, we just thank you for the power of praise. It says that you become what you behold. And so sometimes we're always looking for man to minister or someone else to pray for us. But I just feel like the Lord says, just keep worshiping him tonight. Just keep worshiping Jesus. God, I thank you for the power of worship. It says when we worship you, you inhabit the praises of your people, that heaven crashes in. So, Lord, I just thank you. Give us praise instead of heaviness. And I just felt like, just for people to change just their language of just into praise, just throughout the day, just no matter what's going on, just to stay in that place of praising the Lord. And so I just pray for grace, because we can't do it in our flesh to do that. But Holy Spirit, I just feel like put your hands on your heart. Holy Spirit, I ask that you would help us. You're the helper. Help us to praise the Lord, praise Jesus continually. Well, I pray for grace for that. I just pray, Holy Spirit, that you would give us a new tongue, a new language, a new song on our mouth. I just pray for a new song. Maybe people have been in the wilderness for a long time, in the desert. I pray they would sing a new song starting tonight. They would sing a song of just praising the Lord of the promised land. And so I feel like, could we go a little bit longer? Is it okay? Just like maybe one more song? Is that all right? I feel like we're supposed to go just like one more or two. Is it, you guys okay with that? I'm loving it. This is as good. We're just worshiping him. That's all we're doing. That's our only plan. But for this last maybe one or two songs, I want to first just bless just Tommy, just the worship team, and Alyssa. Let's just extend our hands out to worship team and also Alyssa back there. God, we just pray. It says that those who refresh others, they themselves are refreshed. So I just pray for just a special blessing upon Tommy, upon what you're doing, Lord, upon every worship team, Fisher back there, Nate, the sound. God, we just thank you for just a double blessing upon them. In Jesus' name, we just thank you. And I just felt like when you were doing worship, Tommy, I just felt like there's going to be, I don't know, just pray into this. But I saw the Lord giving you like property or land, something with worship. So be ready for open doors where the Lord just gives you the keys. Because where are you worshiping now? Where's the spot?
So right now we have...
yeah, go for it.
Empty warehouse called the Canine Rehabilitation Center of Orange County. And they move all their fitness dog equipment out of the side, and we have an empty warehouse where we worship.
Yeah.
So.
And where's that exactly? Where's the city?
Santa Ana.
Santa Ana.
Yeah.
So, well, let's just come into agreement just for just a provision. God, unless you want to stay there, you can. There's, nope. I mean, okay. So, Lord, we just thank you for just providing just a place, a building to worship. Mm-hmm. Lord, we thank you that this place is always open door for you to come and worship. But, God, wherever that is, we just thank you in advance for that provision. And I pray for before the end of the year, there would be an open door. We just declare that in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Cool.
Thank you.
Sweet. Yeah.
Such a good word. Thank you. Yeah, no, we could do one more. But before we do, does anybody else have a word? One of my favorite settings that I've ever done worship is at this guy Blaine Cook's house. Some of you may have heard of his name through the Vineyard. But he had a nice living room, and we would do some worship, and then Blaine would give you the nod like, we're done. And then we'd just wait for like 5 minutes, and you're just like, oh my gosh, what's about to happen? Like, the Lord is here. Something's about to happen. And then people would just stand up and start giving the words that God put on their heart during worship. And it's just, you know, I know you can't do that on every Sunday morning church, but we should be meeting in homes in between Sundays and encouraging one another with the gifts of the Spirit. And so, yeah, it's just such an amazing thing. So thanks for sharing that word. So if anyone else has a word, we can just make it a living room tonight. Thank you. I think there was one more behind him, maybe. One more, anybody else? Thank you. All right, well, we're going to jump back into some worship. One song of worship.
I don't know how to say exactly how I feel. I can't begin to tell you what your love has meant. I'm lost forward. This is my desire to pour my love on you like oil upon your feet, like wine for you to drink, like water from my heart. I'll pour my
on your feet.
close out in a prayer just for everyone. If you guys could stand up and just pray a blessing over everyone here. Just want to thank you for being here tonight, taking time out of the week. But God, I thank you. Yeah, I just thank you, Father, that you're looking for worshipers. You're not looking for performers. You're not looking for the best prophets and event. You're looking for worshipers, Lord. And so I just thank you for that's what you're looking for. I thank you for Tommy's heart of just being a worshiper, just worshiping you because you're worthy. It's simple as that. Not so you can give us all these things. It's great when you do, but because you're enough, simply because you're holy and you're worthy to be praised. And so, God, we just thank you that you're worthy to be worshiped, that Jesus is, the Son of God, that you're the Messiah. And I just pray, Lord, that as we leave tonight, that we would just continually just to stay connected with you and worship whatever we're doing in our work and our job, whatever it is. Holy Spirit, help us just keep worshiping you throughout the day and night. God, I thank you for your presence that never leaves us. But God, I thank you for just worshipers here on a Wednesday night. And we just bless everyone here in Jesus' name. Amen. Awesome, guys. Well, thank you for coming. Let's give it one more time to the Lord. And it's for Tommy. Yeah, thank you for taking time. Yeah, hopefully we'll come back. Hopefully we don't worry out too much.
I'd love to.
Okay. Okay, we'll see you guys next time. Amen.
Heard about a threshing floor. Gideon saw the angel of the Lord. Wanna go there and be with you. Heard about a secret place. Moses went and saw your face. Wanna go there and be with you. Take me home. about a threshing floor. Gideon saw angel of the Lord. I wanna go there.